Hi dear friends, my name is Nidheesh. I am pursuing MPhil program in Development Studies at Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai. I did my master's course from here. I did master's in social work. If you are preparing for TISS-NET, both MA or MPhil, you should have a clear idea about why you want to pursue a program in TISS, especially what you are going to do. Why you want to do a course in social sciences especially? So because it will help you in during the interview time. In TISS-NET, especially for MA students, there are mainly three steps. Initially, you need to fill the form. After that, there will be a written exam. It will be objective type exam. For that, you need to read. Basic things, general knowledge only. They will verify. And moreover, basic till 10th standards that we have studied LCM, SCF, those kind of logical things. Those kind of things only they will ask. If you are comparing with SSE or UPSC, TISS-NET is relatively easy. But one thing, what my experience, what I learned is, we should read newspaper regularly. If you are reading newspaper regularly, at least 6 months and over, you can easily crack the TISS-NET exam. Then after that, there will be a person interview and group discussion. It's for depend upon the department, they will conduct the group discussion. Person interview, they will verify, as I told earlier, why you want to pursue a program in TISS. Compared to other institute, what you have seen, differences in TISS. So they will verify that one. Moreover, TISS-NET is if you are looking at other interview, they will very deeply they will screw you. But in TISS, even interview time also, if you are coming from a vernacular medium, if you are not fluent in English, they will help you maximum. As per my experience, I was coming from a rural area. I was not comfortable with the English language when I was doing MA. So I have experienced that professors, they were always helping me, even the person in interview time, because I was not comfortable with the English as well as Hindi at that time. Then I cleared interview also. It was not that much difficult. Then even in the group discussion, sometimes they will give some topic, or sometimes they will show some pictures also. If you are not comfortable with that topic, you don't need to participate in the group discussion in the initial stage. You don't need to begin it. We wait for some time. After 3-4 participants, you can add your own points. So it's also not that much difficult to group discussion. After that, as per your performance, they will publish the result. And there will be a 1 or 2 waiting list also. So, what my experience is, try your best and read newspaper as well as the newspaper like the Hindu, and read the editorial part of the Hindu newspaper, and read Frontline magazine. And if it possible, please approach librarian and the colleges which is nearby you. That will help you during the MA program. In the MPhil, it's slightly different. In the MPhil program, there will be a TISS-RAT exam, research aptitude test. Initially, they will check your research aptitude. In that, there will be a two part of the question paper will be a two part. In the first part, they will verify your research knowledge, research skill. In the second portion, they will verify your knowledge, depend upon your subject, which are the topic you have chosen. Suppose if you are a social work student, as per the social work subject and syllabus, they will ask question. If you are a development studies student, they will ask question based on that, development issues related. So, TISS-RAT also not that much difficult. But one thing understood is you should be very clear about your research proposal. Even the exam time also, if you need to score a higher mark, and if you want to write more about your research, it will help you a lot. So you should be very clear in your research proposal. So when I was writing the TISS RAT exam, it was one advantage I have seen. I was very clear about my research proposal. It helped me while writing the research methodology part as well as the main part also. And after the exam, they will shortlist. Depend upon the ratio, they will release shortlist the people. Based on that, they will conduct a person interview also. Even the person interview also, they will verify our subjective knowledge. So, for me, I was very clear about what I want to do in that topic. So it was easy for me, because in TISS I have seen that there are a lot of professors, they are working in different area. So if you are taking a topic, if you are going to other university, there is a possibility to change. I mean, if you are getting admission also, there is a possibility to change that topic depending upon grades. In here it is not like that. You can choose a professor from anywhere. So there are a lot of professors available in campus, and they are working in different area. So whatever your topic, you should be very clear about your concern. It will help. These are my personal experience. In interview, both MA and MPhil program, I have experiences. I was working in different sectors as a volunteer. So most of the questions were based on that only. So it helped me a lot to make a good rapport with, not only rapport, I mean, it enabled me to comfortable with that interview board. And the most of the follow-up question also was based on that, my work experience only. Both, even MA and MPhil, it was like that. If you are not having work experience, it doesn't matter, because most of the time MA students are not having work experience. So, what my experience is, we should be very clear about why we are studying here and what we are going to do after the social science program. People are in here, I am also from a technical background, but there are a lot of people who completed their engineering graduation or medical background, they are pursuing here. So it doesn't matter from which background you are coming, what you did in your graduation. It's only matter what you are going to do in future. So the most of the questions are based on that only. But initially, I mean, it's a platform for you. If you have done something earlier, so we should be very clear about what we done in past. Because our question, interview board, last question based on that, even graduation or work experience. Rest of the thing, future, you don't need to have a big idea about what you are going to do. But as a social science student, what you can contribute for society, it will be a question, anyway. The rest of the things are general only. I mean, but compared to other institute interview, I've seen TISS interview was very comfortable for me, because I had appeared lot of interview, a lot of reputed institution. But I felt TISS was far better than that. So don't worry about TISS interview or group designation. It will be very easy. Thank you.